Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, we're going to take a look at composite models and a question we got about, should we just have an imported dimension, or does it really need to be in dual mode? Let's go see what happens. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, composite models. This is a feature where you can mix imported data with DirectQuery data and get all sorts of outcomes of your reports to add flexibility to what you're trying to do. So I'm not going to go into all the details of what composite modeling is in this video. We've got some other content that talks about that. But what I want to do is look at a question that we got recently where we were talking about storage modes on a given table. So you can have import, direct query, or dual. What happens if we actually mix imported with direct query and not use dual at all? And why would we want to use dual? I want to dig into what that actually looks like. So enough all this talking, you know what we like to do here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my computer. So I've got a report here. I've got a snazzy little chart that's just looking at sales data across every month. And I've got a slicer here that is just looking at the year 2013. If we go look at the data model, we can see here that I've got a calendar table and I've got my internet sales. The bars on the top here indicate what mode it is in. And so my calendar table, because it's a dashed bar on the top, that blue bar, that means that it's in dual mode. If I go look at advanced here under storage mode, we'll actually see that it says dual. A solid line means it's direct query, and no line at all means it's imported. So let's actually see what happens here when we actually go look at this query. If we go to performance analyzer, we'll go start recording. And if we refresh this visual, it'll come back. We can copy the query, go over to our friend DAX Studio, and let's drop that in. If you have the latest version of DAX Studio, it'll actually ask you if you want to paste in both the DAX and the direct query queries. We do. You know, we've got a pretty clean SQL statement here. So we've got the main select statement, and then we're going to go after our calendar table, and then we've got our filter for 2013. Awesome. So now let's go back and look at this from an import perspective. Same visuals here, except this time my calendar table is a calculated table, so it's imported. So this means that the actual calendar table itself from a Power BI perspective is not represented in the data source. It only exists in my data model. If I'm actually issuing a query and I want to filter on year 2013, it doesn't know how to do that. We have to represent that calendar table in the actual query we send back to the data source. And this is where it gets a little messy and why you want to consider, should we actually use a dual table? So let's take a look at this a little further. The other thing you'll notice here are the indicators on the actual relationship itself. This means it's a limited relationship. They don't exist in the same space. One of them's in direct query, one of them's in the local model itself. So let's go look at the query for this one. Go to view, performance analyzer, start recording, and we'll refresh the visual here. Copy the query. And we'll do both DAX and direct query. And now what you see here is a row for each day in the calendar table. So you see here, here's January 2013. And if we go all the way down, so there's December 31st, 2013. Why? Why do we need every day? We just wanted the year 2013. That's the problem, right? There is no year. The column on the internet sales table is a date. It represents a given day. It's not representing a year per se. If you have your calendar table, you're just filtering down by 2013 and saying, I only want this set of actual days. And because the relationship is on the day, that's actually what it's going to send back. So it's whatever the relationship is on, that's the data that's actually going to end up going back. In the query that we have to send back to the data source, it's going to be a line item for each individual day that has to be represented on the data source itself. This can become problematic, especially if we've got multiple dimensions and we're doing multiple items on that. By having dual, I can represent it in the data model from an import perspective, and I know it's also represented in the data source. And you may ask yourself, well, why do I care if it's in dual? Like, why don't I just leave the whole thing in direct query? You'll notice in my report that my slicer here is going off of the given year. And when we're in dual mode, this slicer can just rely on the imported data. There's no reason for me to go back to the direct query source. So in that case, that slicer is going to be more performant. I'm actually causing less queries to go hit my data source, which means my data source isn't as burdened from a resource perspective. And so having that dimensional items in dual mode allows me to use my slicers and in an imported fashion, but when I'm actually using my visuals, I can rely on the DirectQuery piece of this. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is performance. Overall, right, performance is the biggest thing that we want to do. And I will say that this is going to absolutely depend on your data model structure, and the visuals that you've constructed. If you actually look at the examples that I had, you'll actually see that in the dual mode, we're showing 1.5 seconds. And if we go back to my import, I see 1.7 seconds. Let me clear both of these. Let's also go back and clear the cache here from a data model perspective. And let's go back and see what these are. So let's go refresh the visual. 1.1 seconds, 1.8 seconds. So the dual here is actually slower. What? Adam, you just said to do this dual thing, but it's slower. Why would I do that? It's going to depend on your data, right? I don't know that the indexes on the data source are all optimized. Yeah, I need to go look at the execution plan on the SQL side and make sure that that's as performant as it needs to be. Remember, DirectQuery, it's your data source, right? So is the data source tuned in the most optimal way? In this case, I have no idea. And so that could be a play on the actual performance aspect from a full DirectQuery perspective. So those are things you have to consider as well. And so always start with DirectQuery, then go to dual, and then try out import. To go back to dual or DirectQuery, you've got to kind of revert it back or keep a save file. All right, I want to hand this back to you. Have you been using composite models? Do you even look at dual, or do you have an imported table that it's running okay? Have you check the difference between the two? I want to know. Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.